Hello and welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be about creating this text by using the blend tool. We'll also be using something called as clipping mask to make this look beautiful. So let's begin. You start by opening a new file. Go to File, New. Let's start with 18x8 inches and CMYK, Create. Now I will choose a font which is thick enough so that if you apply some kind of a texture to it or a pattern to it, it shows up really nice. So I'm going to change the font size to 120 and change this to beautiful. But I clearly don't like the thickness of the font, so I'm going to change it to HWTRTZ. This is a font which I got from Adobe Typekit, so you can get it as well. I'll leave a link to this font in the description box. So right now I've set the font size to 120 and the font is HWT Arts. So now we're going to go and make a pattern which we can use to fill inside this text. I'm just going to show you what we can do with the blend tool. Go to your rectangle tool. If you cannot see your rectangle right here, right click and choose the rectangle tool. Then make a rectangle which is like covers the font height, at least this much. Now I'm going to select V on my keyboard to go to the selection tool. Click and drag it below. Hold your option key down, click and hold your shift key and drag to create another rectangle. Make sure you place it somewhere in the center. Now hold your option key down, click and hold shift and drag one more and bring it to the end so that it goes beyond the required text. So the first one should be before your text starts and the last one should be beyond. And the third rectangle can be anywhere in between. It's not necessary that you have to place it in the center, but it's fine. So now we're going to choose colors for this. So the first one, I want the gradient to be pink. And then if you look at this, it's like pink, and then it's light pink, and then it goes pink again, and then purple. So if you're going to do that, there are four different variations right here, but here we have only taken three. So okay, let's go ahead and make it four. So I'm just going to place this somewhere here. I'm going to hold my option key down, click shift and drag and place this here. Now it's good. Now we'll select the last rectangle and choose the purple. I'll leave all the colors, the hex codes, or the link to these particular themes in the description box below. You can pick it up. So I'll choose the last rectangle and go ahead and choose purple from my color library. So if you cannot see the libraries, go to Window and Libraries. If you don't know how to use the libraries, go check out my libraries tutorial. I'll leave the link somewhere over here. So this one, let's make it bright purple. In the first one, we make it pink. In the next one, we have to make it a little lighter. This one probably. This one, I'll just make it pink again. You have your selection tool selected. If not, press V on your keyboard. Select the first one and hold your shift key down and select the second rectangle as well. Now go click on the blend tool. Click on one of the rectangles and then go and click on the second one. So this is really important. If you click on one rectangle, nothing happens. But after that, if you go click on the second one, you can see the blend happening. Now, all you have to do is now click on this one and go back and click on this. So now click again and go and click on this. So you have a really nice gradient, right? You can choose any color that you want and make beautiful gradients, for example. And it's not necessary that it has to be a rectangle. Let me choose an ellipse tool. I'll make a circle right here and I'm going to click, hold option key down, click and shift and drag it out. Now I'll make this, let's make it a really weird color, yellow. And now I'll select both, switch to your selection tool, hold your shift key down and select, go to your blend tool, click on it, click on this circle first and then this circle. And you can see how there's a variation or a really nice blend happening over here. So one thing that happens right here is we are not controlling the number of steps. So that's why you see a gradual change. But sometimes you want some colors which you think you need, like I want a really dark pink and then I want to end with yellow, but in between I want some four colors. In order to do that, you can use this technique as well. So for example, let me draw a circle and I'm gonna go to my selection key, that's V, option, click, shift, drag, and this one I'm gonna mark it as pink. Now I want two more colors in between, so hold your shift and select your blend tool now, and then click on the first object, and the second one, click, hold your option key down or alt key down and then click, so that you get a different menu or whatever right here. So there are two things now, orientation and align to path. So you can change this, experiment with this. Let me just keep it at align to page right now, and then smooth color, so I can do specified steps and give, you know, three and click OK. So you'll get three extra things in between, so you know you have three different colors. And now if you have an object and you want the color in between, all you have to do is draw a circle or any of your object that you have, and then go to your eyedropper tool, which is right here, or you can press I on your keyboard and then go and select this color. And that's how you get, you know, a really nice gradient between two specific colors. So okay, coming back to what we have right here, let me go back to my selection tool and let's just keep this all in the background. And so let me make this white. Okay, so we have these things here. Okay, so now we have our text right here and we have our color gradient as well. So all you have to do is place the text on the gradient. Now we created the text before the gradient, so it's in the background. The text should always be in the front. So all you have to do is press shift, command, and close bracket. It brings the text to the front. You can also do by right clicking and saying arrange and bring to front as well. So now that you have it, select everything, click and drag and select everything, and now right click and say make clipping mask. Your beautiful is really beautiful right now. So all you have to do now is add a little bit of text over here. I'm gonna go to my text tool, click and say amazing. I want a different font, so select everything, go here, and the font that I have used is I don't know, I think it was okay. There are two things which I can use right now, so I'm just gonna go with this. I think it was this. Okay, I'm gonna click and drag it and place it over here, and now I'm gonna make one more, say you, and go back to your selection tool and bring it here. What you can also do is you can select all of these and then go to your you know, horizontal align center and then vertical align center as well. Oh, you shouldn't do that because that's what happens. If you want to use the vertical align center, always group these things. That is Command G or Control G. And then you can click on vertical align and it aligns really well. So yeah, this is basically how we use clipping mask to put an image or any kind of beautiful color gradient into your text. And obviously, this is how you use the blend tool. So if you like my video, please give a thumbs up and hit subscribe so that you get notified whenever a new video gets uploaded. Do go check out my blog. I usually give out free stuff over there. So yeah, it's a win-win situation. So I'll see you next week with another amazing tutorial. If you have any ideas or if you want to learn something, do let me know by leaving a comment below and I'll make a video for you. So until next time, bye bye.